How do I run SQL in Jupyter Notebooks? Hello, welcome to Tech-Minded Recipes. Today we will learn how to run SQL commands on Jupyter Notebooks. You may be asking yourself, why would I want to do that? Let me give you a few examples. You may want to do a quick analysis directly from a database. I find it that sometimes it is just easier to write a quick SQL than to set up a data frame. This is especially true when you have to join one or more tables. Either way, this can be a handy tool on your tool belt to use in the future. Before we start, if you have not yet subscribed the channel, please click on subscribe to be informed about more videos like this. And, if you like this video, please give us our like at the end. Also, please see below in the description to a link to the notebook with all the code in this video. If you are watching this tutorial, I assume you're already familiar with Jupyter Notebooks and have it installed. The first thing we will do is to import the two libraries we will use. We will use the pandas library. Import pandas as pd. And then, we will also import the SQLite library to allow us to create a database and do the demo. Import SQLite 3. If you are just connecting to an existing database, you will not need to take this step. Instead, you will need to import the specific library to connect with the database you will be using. This could be Oracle, MySQL, or whatever other database with a Python API. Next, you will need to install the library, iPython-sql. This library will enable you to run SQL in Jupyter, using Jupyter magic commands. You don't need to understand what I will do right now. If you do, perfect. But, if you don't, do not worry. I will create a quick data frame just to create demo data, that I will then inject into the SQLite database so we have data there to query. df equals pd.DataFrame. Then you will create a dictionary with name, age, and city as keys. Those will serve as the headers of our table. The values of the dictionary will be the rows of each column. Last, we will just call the DataFrame to check we have data. Yes. There you go. This is the DataFrame we just created. Now, we will use the connect method of the SQLite library to connect to the database. Here, since we actually do not have this database yet, the connection command will create a database. If you are using an existing database, it will just create a connection that you will use later. Once you have the connection created, we can just use the do_sql method from the pandas DataFrame to add the data to the database. In this case, we are only using two arguments of the method. The first one is the name of the table that will be created. I am naming it people. And the second one is just the variable I created to hold the connection. Once I ran it, we will have a table in our database that we can then use to run our queries. Until now, all we did was to set up the data in the database. You obviously will not need to do this if you're working with real data. Now we will run a Jupyter line magic to load the SQL module, so Jupyter can use it. You can recognize line magics by looking at the percent sign in the beginning. Those are different from cell magics. You will see later that cell magics use 2% signs instead of 1. We again use a line magic here, but this time, to point the Jupyter SQL library to the database we want to use. That's it. Now we are pretty much ready to run our queries. We will use the notation of 2% signs to create a cell magic, followed by SQL, then just run our queries. Let's run a couple of examples. Select star from people. There. We can see we get all the records we had created. Let's count the number of records in the table. Select count star from people. There you go. One last time. Let's sum the age of the people in the table. Select sum of age as age_sum from people. Once again, as expected, we are able to run SQL directly from Jupyter. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. I would love to see you again here in the future. Do not forget to like this video and to press the subscribe button to watch more videos like this.